We're going to go ahead and get started with the second half of the show. Are we ready? So we're going to go with the energy thing, yeah? So when something exciting happens, what are you supposed to do? Well, I can turn louder than that by myself. Together, ready, go! Oh, there she is. Very good. Miss Yes. All right, first up for the second half, we have Miss Breanna McQueen performing Never Enough from The Greatest Showman.
I'm trying to hold my breath, let it stay this way, can't let this moment end. You set off a dream of me, getting louder now, can you hear it echoing? Take my hand, will you share this with me? Cause starting without you, all the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky, will never be enough, never be enough.
You're always just like, hi, and I'm like an evangelista. I'm a model. I know how to draw eyebrows. I don't know how to draw eyebrows. That's what I was talking about. Okay, anyways. Now we're going to switch it up. This is one of my favorite Broadway musicals. This is the first one I ever saw when I was a little tiny tot. Turned me gay. Here we go, give it up for Wynter Frost with I Just Can't Wait to Be King from the Lion King. Yeah! Nikolai Prince performing Soul of a Man from Kinky.
Shoot us, who's just screwed up? Same old Charlie in the ground. Cause I'll never be the soul of a man. No boy, and why? Soul of a man. Ruling didn't he hurt like the soul of a man? Heroic and true like the soul. Thoughts of music, though confusing, it's sweet.
Drag in Corvallis, so I hope to see more of that very soon. Okay, who am I announcing next? Who? Oh, Miss Dharma. Another tune from Greece for you. The sixth time she's playing Rizzo. Introducing Miss Dharma, Prada McPherson, mother of the House of Dharma, with her Worst Things I Could Do. Give it up for her.
Every night.
for Miss Dharma.
Yes, bitch.
All right, next up we have my lovely co-hostess, Miss Cali Je, performing My Man from Funny Girl. And they're a bunch of talented hookers. She's singing this live. Oh, my man, I love him so. He'll never know. All my life is just despair, and I don't care when he takes me in his arms. The world is bright all around. What's the difference if I say I'll go away, when I know I'll come back on my knees someday? For whatever my man is, I'm his forevermore. Poor goddesses. Don't tell her I said anything. I don't think she heard me. Another bitch. I promise. No. Fuck off. The door's right there. Prove it. Alrighty. I'd like to welcome my next performer to the stage while me and Kurt fuck behind the dumpsters, behind the bar. I earned it. Anastasia from Vonschweets and Misha D, yeah, performing for good. For yes. Good.
Look at you, you handle all I couldn't do.
come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sky, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I can change for the better? Because I'm you. I have been changed for good.
Second to the penultimate performance for the evening comes from Bela De Luna, a reprise, if you will. Coming back up to the stage, giving some more sweet transvestites. Doing I Can Make You a Man from a Rocky Horror Picture Show. Bela De Luna. rippling, weighing in at 90 pounds. We'll get sand in his face when we kick to the grind. And smooth in the gym with the determined chin and the sweat from his paws as he works for his cause. We'll make him listen and lean. Oh, and with massage and just a little bit of he'll be pink and white green. He'll be a strong man. Oh, honey! And by the wrong man. Chin-ups, press-ups, and chin-ups. Do the snatch, clean, jerk. He thinks dynamic tension must be hard work. Such a strenuous thing, I just don't understand. In just 7 days, I can make you a man. High protein and all our raw eggs. We'll have the shoulders. His chest, arms, and legs. Such an effort, if I only knew what I planned. In just 7 days, oh baby, I can make you a man. Sorry, I just had to kill him. He's just so uncivilized. Deltoid and a bicep. Hot groin and a bicep. Makes me shake. Makes me wanna take Charles Atlas by the
this time, huh? Fuck you. Okay, for our last one, see, I have to introduce her because she's my sister. And also, my sister's ma'am is here. This ma'am. That little bitty woman birthed that. Now, ma'am, is a drag virgin, even though she has a drag queen for a son. Weird. So we thought to honor her first time, Misha would do a very special song dedicated just to her. Now, this doesn't really fit in the Broadgay category, but we thought you'd all be super fucking sick of show tunes by now. So we're going to throw in some Meghan Trainor for you. You're welcome.
Get them all like that. Ain't nobody get them all like that.
To your drag day. And a grandmother and a father. All the way from South Carolina. Everybody say love.
Love.
Love. Grandma's gonna talk to you now.
So, after some positivity, I do need to be very real with all of you folks at the end of the show. I know we've had a lot of empowerment through this show, And I hope you folks realize that drag is more than just cross-dressing. If it was just about cross-dressing, then it would be pretty transphobic. The entertainment quality of drag is that these folks are coming on stage and really being themselves. And I want to be very clear. A lot of folks in Corvallis and beyond have been harassing some of my cis drag queen performers. And to the point where folks have been so discouraged that they are going to quit performing drag. And this is really frustrating to me. And I want to make it clear that everybody has a stake in this community. Everybody has a place on this stage. The reason that we started the House of Dharma was to create opportunities for folks who are marginalized, not just necessarily queer and trans folks, but folks who feel other than, folks who feel less than. And we are here to create opportunities for artists who want to share their work. People who have put in work in the community for years and years are being so discouraged from participating in drag that they're quitting. And this is so frustrating to me. This is not what should be happening during Pride. And I know this is bringing down the energy, but I just want to make sure that folks know that this is for everybody. If you want to be on this stage, let me know. If you want to be part of this, House of Dharma is here for you. And it just really breaks my heart that folks would treat people like that. And I just want to make it clear that House of Dharma does not have any sort of agenda for cis or for trans queens being the only people up here, or queer people being the only people up here. It's so frustrating to see people disenfranchise folks for being big and curvy, or for being cisgender, or for not being queer. It's very frustrating because I'm trying to build this community and bring us together. It's about building bridges, not tearing us apart. We've all been oppressed in some way, we've all been marginalized. Enough people probably want you dead for being who you are, so please don't come for each other. Please support and uplift each other. I hope if you learned anything tonight, that being yourself is the most powerful thing that you can do. Allowing others to be themselves not only is empowering, but it saves lives. So please, keep your peers accountable. And understand that if you have questions about drag, talk to us about it. Don't come for people. Don't make them feel less than. Talk to me about it. I'm a safe person to talk to you about your questions about the shit. I never want to see another person quit doing drag in our community because of hatred. This is so uncomfortable. But on a more positive note, I'm so happy that all of you folks are here with us. I'm so glad that Bombs Away and Cloud and Kelly's continually provide us spaces to produce queer art. I'm so happy for Corvallis Pride's committee for helping us make this event happen. Thank you to Jason and Jonathan for helping us with the sound. And thank you to the Bombs Away staff for supporting us tonight. I love you all. Happy fucking Pride, Corvallis. Folks with kiddos, we are doing a drag queen reading time on Monday at the Corvallis Public Library at 7 p.m. Come see me, Cali Je, and Carmen Sutra reading some faggoty ass books to children. We also need some more volunteers for Alt Prom. Alt Prom is an alternative prom for LGBTQ+ folks. That's happening on Saturday, June 16th.
High school.
High school aged folks.
Going to school.
Going to school. Not here. But if you want to volunteer for that, reach out to me at houseofdharma@gmail.com or contact the Pride Corvallis Facebook page so that we can get some more volunteers. Also, we have our big Pride show, the Pride Extravaganza, at the Majestic Theater on June 22nd. It's our very first time working at the Majestic Theater, so we'd love to all have you there. It's gonna fucking sell out, so buy your tickets now and come see my trashy extravaganza. I'd like to welcome all of our performers for the evening back up to the stage. Nikolai, Prince, struggling it up here. Wynter, Prada. All of from Eugene, Oregon, Attila. A local favorite with a sexy ass artist, Breanna, McQueen. But the Go King, Demi Morgan, the attack helmet out there. Finally back with us, House of Dharma's favorite dead girl, Bela De Luna. My favorite Tim's Queen, Viva Royalty 2017, Anastasia Bungalow. She's no longer here because she's been tired of whole person, shared fluids. One of our co-hosts is this morning evening, Miss Misha. Our other lovely co-host is Miss Cali Je. And last but not least, especially that least, myself. Good night, folks. Drive safely. Please not drive drunk. Watch out for trans fans in the crowd. And make sure folks have a safe way home. Happy Bye, Corvallis.